Hi students, how are you? Topic of our today's session is sources of food components. As I taught you in first chapter, there are main two sources for food components: animal products and plants products. Now let us explore the sources of food components. First we see sources of carbohydrates. Can you name some major sources of carbohydrates we get from plants? Some plant sources of carbohydrates are potato, sweet potato, sugarcane, papaya, watermelon, mango, wheat, rice, maize, bajra, etc. All these are plant sources of carbohydrates. Now we see sources of proteins. Gram, peas, soya beans, etc. are some sources of proteins which we obtain from plants. And milk, chicken, fish, egg, paneer are the sources of proteins which we get from animals. Both are rich in proteins. Now let's see about sources of fats. Dietary fats are derived from two main sources: animal sources, ghee, butter, fat of meat, fish, oils, etc. are the sources of animal product. Can you list some plant sources of fats? Various vegetable oils such as groundnut oil, ginger oil, mustard oil, cotton seed and nut oil and coconut oil, etc. are the plant sources of fats. If we see sources of vitamins, vitamin A is present in various animal sources such as egg, butter, ghee, milk, etc. Plant sources rich in vitamin A are carrots, tomatoes, papaya, mango, guava, and leafy vegetables. Vitamin B complex. Some important sources of vitamin B complex are animal liver, wheat, and rice. Vitamin B includes vitamin B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, and B12. If we explore these sources, whole wheat, dried yeast, peanuts, oatmeal, prawn, sunflower seeds, soya beans, sprouts, etc. are the sources of vitamin B1. Dairy products, kidney, yeast, green leafy vegetables, fish, etc. are the sources of vitamin B2. Prawn, mushroom, chicken, peanuts, beef, and rich grains, etc. are the sources of vitamin B3. Yeast, corn, cauliflower, tomatoes, lentils, egg yolks, liver, kidney, peanuts, etc. are the sources of vitamin B5. Cereal grains, yeast, liver, milk, bananas, beef, eggs, etc. are the sources of B6. And beef, liver, eggs, dairy products, shellfish, etc. are the sources of B12. If we explore vitamin C, tomato, orange, guava, lemon and amla are the some important sources of vitamin C. On the other hand, milk, butter, liver, eggs and fish are the important sources of vitamin D. Some important sources of vitamin K are cabbage, tomatoes, spinach and soya bean. Similarly, some important sources of vitamin E are soya bean, vegetables, vegetable oils, leafy green vegetables, sprouts, cereals, eggs, etc. Now we explore the sources of minerals. Minerals are one of the major nutrients required by our body. Iron is a mineral required by our body. It is commonly present in food items such as spinach, liver, apple, etc. Then iodine. Some common sources of iodine are fish, spinach, ginger, etc. Calcium. Common sources of calcium are milk and eggs. Phosphorus. Milk, banana, ghee, green chili, wheat and rice are the important sources of phosphorus. Now some sources of roughage. As I already taught you that roughage are of two types, soluble and insoluble. So roughage is mainly obtained from plant products, for example grains, pulses, fruits and vegetables. These are the important sources of roughage. And at last, some sources of water. Water is lost from our body in the form of sweat and urine. This lost water is replaced by the fluids we consume, such as water, milk, juice, soup, soft drinks, and tea. In addition to these sources, water is also present in fruits and vegetables. For example, if you squeeze a tomato or an orange, you will find water in it. So that's all for the today.